There we go. Apologies about that, boys and girls. But good morning, good evening, good afternoon, everyone. Quick, random, a little bit random group workout with all of you. We are doing the Road to Ruins course, I believe, out here today. Zwift group workout. According to Zwift events, we're going to Road to Ruins. We're taking a right-hand turn, though, off of the pier. So we'll see if that's what we're doing. But it's called Through the Zones that we are doing today for the group workout. And let's get right into it. The format of the broadcast today will be all about doing the workout with interaction with everybody who's hanging out with us in the broadcast today, chatting a little bit about group workout mode, as well as upcoming events on Zwift, kind of a community hangout a little bit, testing out doing more and more with the new group workout mode, as it's a pretty cool new feature out on Zwift. And we've gotten a lot of requests lately for more of the community-based type stuff, so we definitely want to be showing that off to everybody. Hi, Nathan. Wendy May Abbott's here, giving us a great example of the social media integration that we do have in the broadcast today. So Wendy May Abbott saying, hi, Nathan, watching from Tassie. Good to see you, Wendy. If anybody else does have questions or comments, make sure to jump on in to the broadcast over on Zwift Community Live Facebook, or tweet at us at Z Community Live, and we'll go ahead and bring your questions, comments, pictures of your Zwift setup, whatever you might want to bring in for the discussion here while we can. It looks like the workout's going to be 15 minutes at 265. In order for me to be a broadcaster, we're just going to use this nice little percentage drop. We're still going to give a good workout. We're going to do more of a 240 for our tempo today. And we'll make sure that we can still have a discussion. We're not racing. We're not racing. That's not right. We need to get rid of that. Zwift, workout. Let's do that. Workout. There we go. Oh, no. Wait. Is that not right? Here we go. This one? No, this one? And maybe that one. Let's see if that works. We'll see if we can get that to say we're not racing. Just so you guys know, it says racing right there up above the Zwift over there. We'll see if we can get that to not say racing, because we're definitely not in race mode right now. I see where it is at. So we'll get that changed up. Workout. There we go. What's up, Mark Clinton? Says, I'm on it. Are you with us? Are you with us? Oh, yeah, I see you there. Good to see you there, Mark. I see you riding for Team Cookie. I'm going to call you Cookie Monster, if that's all right. Cookie Monster's in the house. Good to see you there, Mark. Glad to have you with us here. And the Cervelo S5. No, okay, maybe I thought maybe there was like an auto onto a certain bike there, because I was seeing a bunch of Cervelo S5s, but it looks like nice unlock there for you, Mark. Casey Sum says, cheater, wish you could view the detailed workout before joining. I actually did check it out on the events page, but I definitely was looking for that, Casey. I'm 100% there with you, that we need to focus in on, in my opinion, it'd be nice if we had more focus on the computer app, the application on the Mac or the desktop. As a user who is very specific to desktop use, having more event description would be nice, Casey, for sure. Cookie Monster for the win. Sean McLean says, I'll be getting a ride in today. Awesome, Sean. Good to hear that, man. Good to hear. And glad. Are you going to be doing one of the workouts, Sean? Are you going to be doing one of the workouts? That's a part of the challenge right now. They got the Hendy challenge going on. Hendy challenge looks pretty cool, actually. I think it's 5 workouts, I believe you need to do. I'm not going to throw my hat in for winning the coaching, but I might complete the challenge, though. See, I don't know if there's a kit or something that you open up, though. That'd be kind of cool. If there were some sort of a kit in-game that you open up, it'd be a little bit more motivation for me, as I'm not super interested personally in getting that. The coaching, at least. But seeing we have a few viewers over at Mixer, can you go check out the Twitch as well? And see if there's anybody chatting over there. I am watching both of those places. Now, I'm wondering if we have this course. I'm wondering if the course is actually going to Road to Ruins. Like, are we doing it backwards? I think that may be what's going on. Because I think that the Road to Ruins actually goes through the volcano at the end. So I have a feeling we're actually doing it in reverse. I'm feeling that's what's going on here. So 10-minute warm-up, long warm-up, which is good. Didn't really get much of a warm-up prior to this, so I'm glad we're not just going right on into, 240 wouldn't be too bad, but we're not going too hard right off the bat. W the Everster, Zastro. Thanks a lot for the ride on. Appreciate it very much. Let's go ahead and throw a little bit of music on. We like to have music during the broadcast for the workout mode, as I think it brings a little bit more motivation for those who are tuning in for the stream to watch the workout mode. Kind of brings that little bit of a group workout environment, indoor environment, more into the broadcast. We just need to make sure that it's not blasting loud. That's the only thing that we need to watch out for here. All right, so there we go. We're all set up with the music now too. Lots going on over the next week. Hope you guys all saw the Team Dimension data rides. I'm going to be live streaming a bunch of that next week. So with live interaction, actually, with some of the riders. So watch out for announcements around that. We'll actually be interacting with Team Dimension Data. So watch out for announcements for schedule of exactly what broadcasts we're going to be doing with the team and the group rides and workouts that will be going on with Team Die Data. It's going to be a pretty cool week next week. A lot of the schedule is going to be around those efforts to build the largest training community out on Zwift next week. 90%? You mean you're actually trying to talk? What's up, Ian Anderson? Yes, I am going to actually try and talk all the way through. We'll see if we get the stars. I'm going to try and go for the stars. I just don't want to fail, Ian. We just don't want to fail. We just don't want to fail, right? And yeah, here's actually some of the details on next week's training camp. So world's largest virtual training camp, November 13th through the 19th, in conjunction with Team Dimension Data, Zwift, and Quebeca. Ride with Reason, and we will be live here with the training camp. Almost every day, I think we're gonna have something live and some interaction as well with riders from Team Die Data as well here and there. So make sure to watch out for when the live streams go live. If you want push notifications, as I always say, anytime that we go live here on ZCL, go on over to our Twitch channel, hit that follow button over there, that'll help you. Make sure you don't miss anything, because the Facebook algorithm is all about what's popular. If you like specific content, you want a notification directly to your email or your Twitch app. You'll find that over at a follow at Twitch. Mason Mike says, have you updated your FTB in game lately? Nope. I have not. I haven't done a test, and I don't even know how long. And if I start training seriously anytime soon, which I might actually, I don't really care. I will force myself to quickly get back to the numbers I like to see. So, I'll have a little while of being at the lower end of my acceptable intervals that are in my head for certain peak power numbers. And then I'll just gain back pretty quickly what I can into more acceptable for my ego. And then hopefully be even stronger with new plateaus. So you're really going to suffer? We'll see. I lowered it to 90%. So 240. If I'm in like good endurance shape, Mike, we're looking at that for solid 2-3. And even my personal best is 260 for up to 5 hours. So that's in really good shape, obviously, but 50 minutes, 240, we'll be okay. Zwift on Board will not be involved with the partnerships, Broly Alfonso, and we have no information just yet. We are, it's coming. I am working on it, just so you know. It's coming. But nope, no info just yet. But it is on its way. Can't give you an exact time frame or anything. I don't want to overpromise and under deliver. So it is on its way though. Ask questions to Dimension Data about the Zwift Academy final. Oh my gosh. What? Use that. Don't listen to Johnny. He doesn't know how to make a good hashtag, it looks like. No, ask questions to... What's up? We can ask questions to Team Dimension Data, but that hashtag might not work out too well. What's up, Andrew Banky? Good to see you over at the Facebook stream. Let's see who we all got here. Actually, I kind of want to turn off the ERG mode so I can like mess around at the front a little bit and see what it does when you go over power. Like here, I go up to 270 and then it like lightens up on me, so I can't ever make my way to the front. It's like people are in ERG mode, a reserve to the back of the pack. I don't know if I like that. Awesome, Andrew. I will not be commentating that one. And maybe in Denver tomorrow. I wish Chicago, hour and a half, 2 hours down the road, but no go for me on that one. And we got a busy weekend, so. Johnny just did hashtag ask. I have no idea if he's just falling apart together or what, but it doesn't seem to be working. I'm not streaming TFC today. I was actually going to do this workout on my personal stream, but we're trying to do more workout content, focus stuff here on ZCL, and, which is really cool. So we went here instead. So my title was Zwift Workout followed by PUBG Marathon. So we'll be doing some personal streaming after this one. Do you have goals in mind for next season that you're going to start training for? Yes. we need to figure out specific races, but we're probably not going to do a focus on a local series or anything. But I'd like to do some major events racing, Mike. Like really focusing on one day or a few day stage races that have a higher caliber and broader reach, kind of a thing, but not as many events. So just get really, really, have a couple lead-in races, make sure the fitness is there, make sure the raceability is there, and then jump into some point-to-points, bigger, broader, farther reach type races. Because I've been racing Midwest Pro USA for 9 years and done it all. And it's time to kind of back off the time requirements there, but still race, I think. So, kind of the plan. I don't think I'm going to be doing road races, Mike. That would require a lot of coordination to race at the level I'd like to, with teams and time commitments and upgrades things, because I'd like to race Pro 1-2, and I can race 1-2 Pro, but not Pro 1-2, I don't think, right now. There's no advantage or sense. You gotta remember, racing professionally is business and fun. So you have to think about, when you're writing that up, what makes sense about what you want for accomplishments, as well as how the advancement in that works. And it doesn't make any sense to try and advance at this point in my career into road racing. If I want to go into higher caliber, I'd have to race extremely locally on the road. Or, I mean, maybe not. I mean, I guess I could use some networking, maybe find a road team to guest ride on, but that's almost rude. So, what's up, Daffin Williams? Oh yeah, racing bike, there's plenty of them. They're like one of the most popular things in mountain bike right now, but they're like more national. They have a lot more national pull. GNCCL, you're hilarious, Johnny. Not sure that would go over too well. So Andrew says, Denver would be nice, have fun. Thanks, man. It's a little up in the air, but I think we're doing it. I think it's happening. So something about short amounts of time to work out, that's been my theme lately. And you can get so much done in just 30 to 60 minutes. That's what's great about these workouts. But you really want HIT. You gotta have high intensity in there, right? So as you can see here, this workout up front essentially has a good solid warm up, 10 minutes. Plus even this like tempo and high endurance range for a little bit before it really kicks in with the through the zones. Now, I would even push a little further for short HIT. This says day 3 of a program. So if this is supposed to be like a week-long program, then I'm assuming this is kind of a mid-stress ride on purpose. This is the type of ride that's not going to push you insanely, but it's definitely going to get some stress response looking at it. So, but if day-to-day all you have is 30 to 60 minutes for longevity, health reasons, actually, aging slower, that's the best stuff. Actually, been some studies that have showed for some things, that the really long, high endurance stuff, the kind of stuff we put ourselves through as pros, you know, 20 to 30 hour weeks, and that stuff actually ages you more. But the HIT is some of the best, shorter HIT. Maybe not the best for winning races, but the best for general health. That's not going to happen, Racing Mike. It's not going to happen with the chats linked. Some days we'll just shut down one or the other, the focus places too. So, Mike, is that about the chat linking? I think that makes a lot of sense for personal streams. Like, that's great. The whole idea of getting those two places to interact so that you have more chat coming through on personal streams. It's great. Get the name out there for what you're trying to do. But it doesn't make a lot of sense for presenting on a community space in a way that makes sense. If we had a bot coming through chatting in ZCL and someone was just beginning to interact with it, they'd be extremely confused and would be posing more questions than answers. And I would really rather focus on growing a community in a single space. James Hodges is interacting here with a great little comment. Funny you should mention the ability to see details of a workout before joining Casey Shun. I have something planned. For Zwift Power over the weekend. Awesome, James. James actually Hodges, that is his middle name, right? James the actually Hodges in the house. One of the main packs behind Zwift Power. So much thanks to go out to him with all the time he's put into that, in conjunction with the rest of the team over there at ZP. So thanks a lot, James, for your comment. Look forward to the new development over at ZP, ZwiftPower.com. All right, 25 more seconds. All right, it's come up a little bit. We're nice and warmed up. Heading into the new ruins. Here we go. I want freedom. I want freedom from ERG mode. Freedom! I have blue faces on my mind now. Freedom. Oh man. Anyone born after 90 is like, what, dude? What are you talking about? Yep, growing the community is more important. That's for sure, Racing Mike. It is more important. And if we have to make moves to be just like, I'd like to be as transparent as possible. And like, if we have to make moves in order to grow the community in a certain space, then we'll do that. And we'll force some things at certain times so that the reach and the mission of growing fitness in a virtual environment so it can get to as many people as possible. And that people, because like there's just a general knowledge of it, that nobody knows this exists in a lot of these platforms like Twitch. Mixer's been fairly saturated, and we don't have a lot of Xbox features recently or front page features over there. So without that, the reach into Mixer no longer makes a whole lot of sense. A lot of the reach of ZCL into Mixer came from, this is like full transparency, my personal stream being partnered over on Mixer, right? And so that was kind of meshing with ZCL, but that has come to an end. And so my personal streaming on Mixer as a partner with Mixer is still a thing I do, which is awesome. But ZCL is a separate entity and needs to make sense out of how it grows its community to reach as many people as we possibly can to grow the Zwift community, and growing fitness through this awesome platform of virtual cycling together and running and rowing, etc. So if people understand that mission and can let go of platform biases and things like that and just go to where it makes the most sense for the best push for that mission to be a community of fitness together, and they should be viewing on the platform we're looking forward to growing on. So exactly Johnny. Casey Chum says yes, James. Let's see this here. I'm with you there, Casey, for sure. Totally with you. So Casey's saying, yes, James, I want full workout detail ahead of time. Some of these group workouts are not even public Zwift workouts in the app. So it is kind of, I think it's beta still, Casey, but yeah, it's, I wouldn't be surprised if there's plans for that to come. And I think they hear you on it. Probably hear you right now. So it's a good comment to make. All right, what do we got going on here? 126. I need a new hat. All right, that's a good comment too. Let's get a new hat. I do need a new hat. I'm with you. I'm not sure they've made Big Z hats yet. We need some Big Z hats, right? Where are the Big Z hats at? I feel like that's like a new rap song. Where are the Big Z hats at? Where's the Big Z hat? Where are my hats at? Where are my hats at? Come on now. Oh man. Now, another thing that we haven't covered a whole lot, about to start up here, so things are gonna get quiet for probably about, I'll be able to talk for the first six, going into the last four might be a little more difficult. But the Tour de Zwift North America is going on as well. Presented by Cyclops. This is events actually happening on Zwift. Let me see if I can get all the details up here for you real quick. Ooh, here we go. So if you complete all six stages, so there's the first stage starts tomorrow, actually. So Tour de Zwift North America starts up tomorrow. And it's a six-stage event open to all Zwifters, featuring a mix of flat, hilly, and mountain stages. The Cyclops Tour de Zwift is a personal endurance challenge as you compete against others, yourself, and the clock. Results will be displayed when you finish. Complete five of the six stages, and you're eligible to win prizes from Cyclops. So, first one, tomorrow, Saturday, November 11th, starts at 8 a.m. my time, Central Standard Time. So that would be 2 p.m. British UK time, whatever you guys are calling it over there right now. I've been using BST, and they're like, dude, it's not summer. What, it's not summer, Nathan. We just are CST all year long, Central Standard. So I just figured British Standard Time. Like, it's still British time, right? Like, it can just be British time and not seasonal, right? Or no? But anyways, and I am in miles right now for all you guys looking on. All right. So, but that Tour de Zwift does start tomorrow. It looks like stage one is going to be Road to Ruins. Stage two, London Loop. Stage three is going to be London Classic. For, I don't know how many laps that is. Probably three laps. Stage four, Volcano Flat. Stage five, Hilly Watopia. And then London Pretzel on November 26th for stage six. And they're separated by, it looks like, 2 to 3 days each. There's a little rest in between each one. Pretty cool. Pretty cool setup. .322 left in this one. Let me get some more scenes here for you guys. I wonder if we're gonna complete the entire loop before the workout's over. Did I get Mrs. Coach anything good for her birthday, Racing Mike says. The kids were gone all weekend. That's what we got. And the phone was pretty much turned off. We went out a lot. It was fun. That's the best gift ever, yep. But it was kind of weird at times. You know, we have five kiddos, right? So, it was kind of odd as it was totally quiet, Mike, at night. Well, during the day and everything. Like, it was just like, this is what it's going to be like in 10 years. We're going to have to find some things to do. No, not really. We have plenty to do, but we obviously are very active and can always fill the spaces, but it was just interesting not having a whole lot of craziness in the midst of all the silent, you know, the activity that we always have going on here, so. So Johnny says, yeah, call it. Why call it summer when we have none? You guys have no summer. We had a little back and forth interaction about the weather. Guess we're talking about the weather now. The reason Simon called that very British in one of our Zwift casts. Is that like a British thing to do? More kids. Okay, Casey. You're funny. So, but it was 11 degrees Fahrenheit this morning. Fahrenheit, okay? Fahrenheit. And I showed Johnny earlier this morning. That was 11 degrees Fahrenheit. He sent me back a 7 degrees Celsius. And I was like, don't even. We're talking. Math is hard. We're talking 21 degrees below zero Fahrenheit. I mean, not even zero. Not even zero Celsius. Okay? Come at me, bro. No way. All right, here we go. 11 degrees and sweating like a maniac on Zwift. Here we go. The hammer's squealing a little bit too much. Ah, it's not coming too bad. Okay, good. We'll bring it up. A little more entertainment. Here we go. This is a great tweet. This is a great tweet. Johnny. Asking me what I think of the new Zwift Velodrome. So it's not actually a Zwift Velodrome, but there's been a lot of questions about adding one. I'm a huge proponent of matchmaking on the Velodrome. I think it'd be awesome. Just a Velodrome though, all by its lonesome, and putting 1,000 people on it. Now, matchmaking on a Velodrome with heats of 8, that's why Velodromes are popular. Matchmaking, because that's what you do on a Velodrome. Matchmake and go with 8 to 10 riders. It'd be amazing. Alright, here we go. Last part. 1 minute, 365. This is gonna hurt. Red circle of death. Here we go. All stars, baby. Let's go. One more time. USA. I think you missed one of the steps there in the drawing conclusions without complete information thingamajinger there. So yeah, it'll say -4C. Whew. Quite a difference. 7 degrees. Biked freaking Iceland Iceland in 7 degrees or 1300 miles or kilometers. Don't even start, Johnny, that's cold. It ain't cold. I just gotta learn what cold is over there. Talking about weather, I understand how you could ever complain about weather if it never goes below zero. There's an oblet. Living through here. Casey's saying, just trying to hurt us with all these races. NA Tour, E-Crit, ZHR Masters, SCR, Local CX Series, I might have a problem. There's a lot of series in 1 month. Well, looks like three of the two things you listed are community-oriented, but... If you do all the Zwift ones, you might be okay. But that sounds like a little much, Casey. Little much, but I know you got a huge amount of base, so you may be able to recover quickly from it. For those of you who are not familiar with what I'm talking about there, the base training, a lot of base training, when you're not racing big endurance events, a lot of people are like, well, what do you need all those big miles for? There's a couple of things, two things mainly though, is efficiency with new energy sources that you might not be used to using. So sugar, glycogen, being the main one that we mostly use for high intensity efforts to go. But because the best times you're gonna get are at those high intensity efforts, right? The reservation of the energy source that's used in order to make those high intensity efforts being sugar. If those reserves are higher as you're cycling, your ability to go super hard at crucial moments is gonna be greater. And so the base training that you do is all about increasing reserves, because when you do those long rides, your body responds and says, wow, we need a lot more glycogen than the 1 hour that guy was doing. He's doing, or she's doing, 3 hours now? Load them up, right? So a lot of people go out and do a 3 hour ride and be like, why did I gain weight after doing these big rides? I did 3 weeks or 4 weeks of big rides and I gained weight. Your body fat might have went down, glycogen stores went up. You gained that much more water and glycogen into the muscles that you might have gained some weight. If you're at like you start getting to the point of marginal gains, you know, upfront fitness gains, they're gonna be dramatic. There's gonna be weight loss. There's gonna be all these great things happening, right? But, all right, anyways, the other thing about the endurance is that you back off the base in the endurance and you have all this extra energy. You have all this extra faster recovery times that allow you to start pushing more times per week. Your recovery becomes so much faster because of all the base you put in that when it comes time to do HIT, you can do it more often. So you can get more stress response and get stronger from all the stress response. It's the whole reason why you had people using PEDs was to enhance the processes of recovery. There's all these awesome natural ways you can do that, like base training, to enhance recovery, which will make it so that when it comes time to train really hard, you'll be able to do it more often. How did we get on that topic? I don't even know. Oh yeah, Casey, with how much riding he does, may be able to handle everything it sounds like he's throwing at himself. No longer to go. Here we go. One more set through the zones. So what we're doing is a high tempo-ish. Right now for six, threshold-ish for three, and then VO2 for one. Kev Steven, what's up, Kev? All about that bass. About that bass. All right, Kev. And so this week, Johnny and Bonnie Scotland. Really? We're supposed to get snow here soon, too. It's a little dry yet, though. We're going to need some moisture in the air. It's just cold, dry right now. James Hodges says, any losing weight over the winter is doing it wrong. I don't know. Mrs. Coach might have a disagreement with Mr. Hodges, but it depends on where you're at going into the winter. Winter being one of the best times to focus on weight loss if you need to lose weight in race season. Because if you try and lose weight during race season, you sometimes have to sacrifice high intensity, because you sometimes have to be low on calories, low on energy, in order to get that weight loss going at times. So a lot of times weight loss is really good to do out of season if you need to lose it for race season. What is going on with the music? Not playing through. Oh, we're up in the tempo. Up in the tempo. Here we go. Heart rate's starting to match the effort. So it's good this workout, the way it works. It gets you into that zone. It understands you're supposed to be in, then pushes you after that. It understands it takes about five to six minutes to really get into that zone. And then push it in the threshold, which is more in the high 170s for me. For three, you're gonna see us in the 180s for that one. I'm super spun out in the last one, so I'm gonna shift down, see if I can get ERG to get me some more gear, because it was almost too much. I started spinning out in the last one. Should expect to gain about 7 to 8 beats right here. Muscle says he has a confession to make. What's this all about now? In the middle of an interval? Oh my gosh. Banter at 180. Here we go. In the 190s, Steve? Mid-190s? If I'm super trained, it goes down though. It's higher when I'm not in like peak fitness. Steve was answering what my max heart rate is, for those of you who are wondering. What the heck am I talking about? All right, things are about to really hurt. Thanks, Chad. Didn't know that. I updated it about a week ago. 32. Double check. Here we go. There you go, boys and girls, you did it. Ah. Uh-oh. We might fail. 220. Tricksters with the 220. Thanks, Lee Gosden. Appreciate the muscle, man. Sun's out. Sun's not out. I don't know, Lee. So, Gabby Neese was saying that the last firmware on the hammer, now reports, estimated cadence from power pulses, so I like the power tap hub. So I need a separate sensor. I like that. Sorry, I killed the headphones here. Let me plug them back in, guys. I ripped them out. There we go. Chad, I'll get right on it, man. Thanks. What's up, Rick Chain? Thanks, man. Appreciate the encouragement. .220 is not a cooldown. Coming down to 200, though. Yeah, about that, Allison. Maybe a little bit more. We'll be okay, though. That's for today. Trying to get the clock right for next week, so we just stayed up. Next week's gonna be crazy. I don't even know if there's gonna be a clock next week. There we go. Now it's starting to come down. I might have failed this one. I might get 10 of 11. I messed up early on. At first it told me way lower. It came down to 220, so. All right, next time, we up it by 10%. How about that? Okay? Up it by 10%. Here we go. Yeah, that's cool, Chad. Not too worried about it. Sounds good. I like it. I'm not like, same way I am with my power. Give me a range, no big deal. Give me a range, no big deal. Some days we got 350, let's go to the mountain. Some days we got 310, gotta make the mountain anyways. Put the work in, get the work done. And if that's a little off in reading, as long as you know your RPEs, along with your heart rates, you should be good to go. People need all objective measurements, every one of them. You gotta use that RPE scale, right along with power. Don't get so neurotic about power. It's the best objective measurement, but it can't tell you everything. Your body's the one that tells you the most. Yeah, this is a good workout, Steve, I like it. It doesn't stress you too much, but it's enough to get some response. I like it a lot. I like it a lot. Good little kick. Dr. Wally Muscles. What's up with this guy and talking about butt cracks? Come on, man. Everybody screenshot? ZVA? Hey, Dr. Wally. Dave Crisp says, getting ready for Canada, the Tropic Workout. Heck yeah, dude. Oh, good, man. All right, so this is the cool show you what you did screen ride report. Steve Carter says, this has been an extremely informative ZCL broadcast. Zwiftcast is the podcast, but I appreciate it. I appreciate that so much. Thanks, Nathan. Learn more about group workouts, Tour de Zwift North American Glycogen and 5Kids. My goodness, great job, man. Always fun. All stars. Thanks, Steve. I appreciate you, man. I did get 11-11. Yeah, baby. But I appreciate that so much. Maybe we need to get Swiftcast man Simon on here to do some workouts with them. We recently nicknamed the Sloth Simon over out on Simon the Sloth over at Road to Ruin. So maybe we can redeem that to a different name if we can get him out on a workout with me. We'll put him right below me here, hey? In that one, and you guys can see Simon live right below me. How about everybody messages? Everyone head on over to Zwiftcast Listeners and hit that follow button on Zwiftcast Listeners Facebook page. And then leave a message. Somebody start a message chain to invite Simon into a group workout with me live here on Zwift Community Live. I know he can do it. I know we have the equipment in-house over there. So let's make it happen. How about a live workout with Simon and Shane for a group workout, group ride? That would be an amazing, we maybe even make an event for it in Zwift. Does Simon have a bike? Casey says, oh my gosh, I love it. Haza McFaza says, great info, thanks very much. No problem, Haza. Know anything about the Mayan mountain climb? Ooh, Lee. Sorry, man, can't give you too much there, but there's something. There's some awesomeness. All I can say is amazing. Overwatch coming through. Amazing. All right, for those of you who got that one, those of you who don't, scientists with glasses that are cute. Okay, does Simon have a bike? I don't know. Any more? Well, keep on going through them. Keep them coming. We'll keep answering questions. Yeah, PUBG from the bike not happening. We already did our cooldown. We're going to just get chicken dinners. Just going to get chicken dinners on my personal channel all day long. That would be great. Shane, Nathan, Simon, heck yeah. Let's get it going, John Farr. Somebody head over there, make that post on Zwiftcast Listeners, and make sure to follow that page for all Zwiftcast stuff. This is Zwift Community Live, where all things live streaming happen with Zwift and the community. Make sure to follow our Twitch channel. Head on over to twitch.tv/Zwift Community Live for push notifications anytime that we do go live with any content on Zwift Community Live. That is the best way, hands down, to get live communication from us about whenever we go live, as well as having chat up and ready to go that does not disappear quickly and interacting with others. So that's the place to be. All right, let's take a look here. We did 214 average. We had 151 heart rate distribution, 406 for max, 190s. Heck yeah, critical power. This is where we went. Look at all of the awesome people we rode with. Well, we see three. We should be able to see more than that. Why can't we see these are the guys we were closest to most of the time or something? Like, why is it to show these three guys? I don't know what that's all about. But thank you for all the ride-ons. Appreciate you guys. Rock. I can't wait for the update. Did you guys see in the Zwiftcast, Eric had talked about new currency? I cannot wait for the ways that that will be expressed in-game, because we have saved up a lot of stuff. And we need some new levels. Need some new levels. I want some new stuff. I want to do things. I want dailies. I want to be able to do daily quests in Zwift that I can go after and get fit doing them and earn things to be awesome and show off titles that I gained because I'm amazing. Look at the kings and queens of Sufferlandia. People like put that title over themselves in this game already. Like, think if you could like earn things in this game that made you like a boss, right? Like, you demolished that raid like World of Warcraft. I was like a gladiator and earned that by doing like tons of work with my buddies to just completely dominate arena. It'd be amazing if we could do that in Zwift and get fit while doing it too. Come on, let's go. All right. Are any Zwift NA Tour events going to be live streamed? I don't think so, Allison. I don't think so. Pretty sure no. But that's a good question. Good question. Thanks, Allison. Looking through here a little more. All right, looks like we're good on questions. All right, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. My name's Nathan Guerra, coming at you from Zwift's Community Live. If you haven't done so, make sure to head on over to our Twitch channel, hit that follow button. twitch.tv/Zwift Community Live. I am going to go take a shower. That was a great, great workout. Remember, we have coming up, obviously, the Crit Series North America presented by Cyclops. Monday nights, starting at 6:30 CST for the Eastern region, the Central region, 7:30 CST, and then also 9:30 CST for the Western region. We also have the Europe Series presented by Tax, and that is at 1 p.m. Central Standard Time for that series. And the top 10 men and women from both those series will be going to the finals. So get in on the competition as well as join in on the broadcast. We obviously also have next week going on the world's largest virtual training camp, November 13th through the 19th. Absolutely awesome. With Team Dimension Data, Zwift and Quebeca Foundation. Right, with the reason, we're going to be broadcasting some of that live with some of the athletes, actually. So make sure to be checking that out. Tour de Zwift's going on as well. You can search Tour de Zwift North America. Lots of details about that out there over on Zwift's events page. And then there's also a little bit of a message here from Cav. What is going on with the training camp next week?
Team Dimension Data was just a club a few years ago. It was a small club race in South Africa, and to see what it's grown to be, a world tour team winning stage of Grand Tours, it's pretty phenomenal now. We do something different. We support a charity, Quebeca, and we always do a bike handover every year. It really gives a whole different perspective to why we race. We're at our training camp in South Africa in November. We're going to be doing group rides on Zwift every day. It gives people the opportunity to ride, although virtually, to ride in real time with Team Dimension Data Pros, which is pretty cool. Like, we get to ride with other people, you know. Like, we race together all year, the guys in the team. I don't want us to sit and ride next to Mark Renshaw for the rest of the year, so it's a nice incentive to kind of ride with other people from all across the world. Join me and Team Dimension Data for Quebeca, 13th and 19th of November. We'll create the world's biggest training camp. Everyone's invited.